啊，那么其实我说的刚才图片放的，大家认可的、有规模的、有整个管理体系的，就是按照美术馆要求的管理体系的，活跃的，那么我就算民营就算了12个啊，这是我个人的的感觉，那么当代的为主是一个，古代与当代结合的有2个，那么近现代的3个都是公立的啊，主要都是当代的。那么民营美术馆的背景，主要是企业背景是产业为主，地产为主，那么也有金融一家，也有实业的，也有拍卖跟拍卖行合作的，不是有拍卖行背景的，有收藏家背景的。那么创办者来自于内地为主的，还有香港、台湾、印尼啊。那民营美术馆，它的除了开馆，它最活跃的一个特点就是，它推动国际化的展览。这个国际化展览，从西马开始，它不是做以前的流派的，比如 Annie Warhol，比如说波伊斯啊这种，它是做当下的最活跃的顶级的艺术家，它是强调了与发展与国际当代艺术家最新的发展直接接轨，因为这些都是继续创作的艺术家，跟他做大型个展，他过来跟你交流交谈，就会产生很大的影响。对我们的当代就中国的艺术发展会，当代艺术发展有很大的影响。它不是做美术史的回顾的，现代当代的，就做马上现在的比如你看到 Tony Clark、香斯科里马丁草间弥生、艾利艾松等等现在正在做的 Antony Gomery 都是现在非常活跃的大师级的艺术家，他们做这个这跟以前不一样。你看到那还有 Quartz Quartz 那个做玩偶的，对吧？包括建筑，我做建筑那个是魏延武那么还有一个特点就是上海的民营美术馆做的展览，掀起了观众看展览的高潮你看这么多人看展览这是以前没有的。比如说原研哉的展览、设计展览、迪奥的展览、草间弥生展览、莫奈的展览，很多展览都超过30万观众。那么这个30万观众对官方来说免费的，不稀奇，但都是付费的，在国内以前没有的，对吧？现在的费用有的时候150块到200块，都有很多人来看。这就是上海跟别的城市不大一样，比如说莫奈那是有30多万、35万。敦煌与当代的展览是有32万那么草间弥生也有30万都是不断的创造的看人的一个高潮也培养了观众。那么上海民营美术馆崛起的基础和原因呢？第一个，它有一个较多的观众，艺术观众第二个，上海文化本身具有开放性、国际性有对新艺术的包容性。那么，上海美术馆管理人员呢，来自跨地区的法国、韩国、香港特别这10年来有5个馆长是来自于台湾的你们知道骆荣枝一个批评家，对吧？他在上海好多年，做那个上海当代赖香凝把外滩美术馆做得轰轰烈烈的那么现在外滩美术馆也没有那么火，那是他来的时候做得最火的最有高潮的时候。那么王胜之也现在也在还有 K 代赖淑珍在正大美术馆，那么还有最新的吕美仪她也是喜马拉雅美术馆出来的，现在做 K11的馆长所以这个跨地区会有更多新的想法来推动这个美术馆的发展。那么地方政府相当支持的政策和有些文化场馆的规划，也帮助了美术馆的发展第一个就是西岸美术馆那么是政府民营共同开发的还有浦东的馆，对吧？那么上海民艺术馆还有一点非常重视艺术观众的培养因为时间关系不多讲了有非常重视公共教育和观众的培养。那么上海美术馆在发展中的一个可持续的问题，就是 社会上管理还是有缺席的，美术馆称呼是乱用啊，太多啊。那么美术馆较少有比较少的有个性啊啊，还没有建立稳定的就是同质化相同太多是当代的，这个馆可以做，那个馆还能做，的分别只有几个馆有分别，很多馆都不能分别，这是一个问题啊，还不能有推出中国新一代当代艺术家的那个能力啊。那么还最重要的，很多美术馆民营的缺乏稳定的经济经费的支持，造血能力还不强，那么啊，那么还缺少一个啊美术馆的长远的文化目标啊。那么上海除了有这个美术馆发展基础，周围也有，上海有很多大型的当代艺术的活动啊，包括双年展，包括艺博会啊。那么在上海还有很多缺陷，要成为中国的一个艺术中心，要回到以前中国艺术中心啊，因为中间一段阶段是北京成为中国的艺术中心，如果要成为中国当代艺术的一个视觉艺术中心，还缺乏一流的美术学校，缺乏理论的团队，缺乏小型艺术空间来培养艺术家啊，还不能聚集大批的艺术家在上海发展，因为艺术家最多的还是在北京，那么缺少鼓励啊，艺术家发展的啊一个社会没有这样的一个政策，优惠政策和鼓励政策，那么需要民间跟政府一起合作来制定长远的发展目标，不仅仅是有硬件啊，只是造美术馆、造场馆为主的发展方向，必须要回到软件来，那么上海才能够有更好的发展。啊，谢谢大家。
接下来让我们欢迎中岛龙太馆长上台分享，谢谢。
Good day to you all. I'm Ryuta Nakajima, director of the Seiji Tongo Memorial Sampo Japan Nippokowa Museum of Art. And so, before I present the business case of art and CSR, allow me to share with you a few of the Sampo and Sampo Japan Nippokowa group activities. Slide, please. In the morning part, I said that this our museum is on the 42nd floor of the Sampo Japan Nippokowa headquarters building in Tokyo. And the museum opened when the building was completed in 1976 on the highest floor at 180 meters from above ground. And this is the commanding view from the floor, as you can see on the screen. Visitors to the museum were greeted with this fabulous panorama before they enter the exhibition room. And the museum is operated by the Sampo Japan Nippokowa Fine Art and Foundation and established in 1976. The museum holds special exhibitions 5 or 6 times a year, and in recent year has attracted 150 to 160 visitors annually. A total of around 5 million visitors have come to the museum in the 40 years since it opened. So, first of all, I will present the idea behind the direct activities of the Fine Art Foundation and the museum from the three viewpoints. So at first, the first is the folding of exhibitions. We focus on three basic propositions when it comes to planning the annual exhibition schedule. We hold 2 or 3 special exhibitions every year for our wide audience. We publicize these activities starting with the opening ceremony, sometimes with ambassadors of the countries. The second is the converting families and children into fans to the museum. For example, last summer, we held Magical Art Museum, that is this. And our visitors enjoyed and took part in illusions and light and shadow. And the third is supporting artists. We held an art contest called FACE, and which stands for Frontier Artist Contest Exhibition. It's extensively publicized and exhibited all the winning works for 1 month. And that is not all. And once every 3 years, we present a month-long exhibition titled The Way of Paintings. And for the top 12 prize winners, we constantly and regularly conduct these activities to discover and foster new artists. Next, allow me to present a little more detail on supporting artists using FACE. The grand prize awarded at the contest is purchased by the museum for 3 million yen, and the work is added to our collection. The exhibition showed around 70 works selected from among all of the submitted works. The grand awards ceremony and party was also held on the 43rd floor the day before the opening. It was an event with around 250 invitees, including the nearly 60 artists who won awards in the contest, their families, media, journalists, critics, and art gallery people. And we put a lot of effort into inviting as many media gallery people, art magazine, and critics as possible. That is because it is an important task of the host to capitalize on the event as a venue for new promising artists and art galleries to mix and mingle, leading to exciting new opportunities for the artists. It is a month-long exhibition visited by some 10,000 people. Visitors asked to vote on the audience prize, in an interesting initiative that gives insight into popular tastes. As a museum, we are certainly a collector, but our current position is that rather than simply adding to the size of our collection, we should work hard to contribute as a connector, bridge, for artists and art world through this consistent schedule of activities. Next, okay. And next is about our support for art education. We opened the museum for school to use 15 to 20 days every year, taking advantage of the official closed Mondays. We are convinced that art and culture will continue to enrich society and the mind of people into the future. That is why we want art and culture to flourish together with people and society as part of our lives. And it's the next generation, children, who hold the key to our future. That is why we have organized this activity since 2008. We found it vital that from the time we are children, we get to see real world, feel that it is something familiar to us, and develop an aesthetic sense through art education. To date, 15,000 children have taken part in the program, and we tend to continue this in close collaboration with the community.